Thank you for the opportunity, because I think this is a unique opportunity in which we can actually share with you how we have gone from our own mess into our own garden, and maybe some paths will cross with the trip that you have to perform in the health sector. I'm going to present today something that we called a lighthouse initiative that has been running for the last 3 years. That is the Boost 4.0 initiative, that is the largest Industry 4.0 initiative dealing with data spaces and big data. This was a massive, so really large initiative at the industrial level that was trying to shape up this type of ecosystems, implementing concurrently and at the same time 13 different large scale pilots. So we are talking about trials, not proof of concepts, of more than 40 different processes that could be supported by this type of infrastructure. I'm actually very pleased to see that some of the technologies like Gaia X or the International Data Space that have been already introduced by previous speakers are the same technologies that we have piloted and trialed in this initiative. And actually, I would like to start from a very simple observation that we have made in this process. In our case, everything is about linking things with platforms, but with a process view. And the process is actually what is translating business model into operational aspects that can actually reveal the value of the data. And this is important since in our case, we are implementing a large number of different processes on the same structure for our production and engineering data spaces. Because at the end of the day, what are driving these large-scale trials is the effort of the industry to drive the data economy. But what are actually the barriers that we have observed when we had to develop these business-to-business data spaces and data ecosystems? The first barrier is trust and openness. Actually, when we talk to the people during the project, we have seen that revealing variable data, loss of control, inconsistent processes, and the fear of not selecting the right platform with the critical mass and to be in a lock-in process were the main fears that they had. They also fear cost and interoperability. And at the end of the project, what we have realized is that all this effort of creating a data ecosystem, actually 70 and 80% of the cost of this process is actually related to data preparation and data processing. And this implies that a single company can solve their own problem, but it's important to have a scale. And it is important to have an ecosystem approach and a data sharing perspective from the very beginning. And the third barrier is actually continuity and controlled free flow of data. We had to work with these information silos that were our main challenge. So in front of us, we have a very difficult road that we have to fulfill. So which were the building blocks that we identified to obtain this kind of KPIs that are the results that the companies are experiencing after 3 years of large-scale trials for the use of these data technologies and data ecosystems. If you want to know more about the actual process that we have implemented, you can join us next week in our conference. But today, let's start sharing the foundations, which are the three key elements that are common to all the data ecosystems and data spaces that we have created. We are sharing the same rules, and I think you already, some of the speakers already highlighted the importance of the rule book. This is instrumental and this is central to development of this data ecosystem. Certification, data access, and usage control. So even if we are implementing data-driven processes, we have to think data sharing by design. If we do the design of these data sharing strategies afterwards, the cost of implementing these ecosystems increase exponentially. Also, as part of the OpenDI and as part of the reflection that we have performed during this piloting process, we have identified the 9 enablers and the 9 dimensions that need to be defined across the different stakeholders taking place and taking part in a data sharing ecosystem. You can see in this slide that there are basically 2 types of agreements that need to be put in place to realize the type of KPIs that I was describing before. On one hand, technical agreements that I would agree with the previous speaker are actually the least difficult to meet. And then industrial agreements that are actually connected to defining business model, fair sharing of data, operational agreements, and legal ones. I will just take the last 30 seconds of my presentation actually to start making a connection between this effort that we have implemented in building our manufacturing data ecosystems, now trying to understand how these manufacturing data ecosystems can actually be put in place to fight against COVID. And let me share with you an initiative we started yesterday at European level that is actually trying to put manufacturing repurposing ecosystems, data ecosystems, to improve our preparedness and responsiveness to the manufacturing demands that pandemics and shared pandemics like COVID-19 put on our sector. This is going to be a very large initiative where we are going to start dialogue and cooperations with a large set of ecosystems and associations, including EHTEL, and here you can actually see which are the main elements that we plan to put together in this data ecosystem that should help us to realize really a plug and response manufacturing capability for future waves of COVID-19 pandemics. If you are interested, you can find additional information in these links. So thank you very much for inviting us today.